It's no surprise that a theater is a place for expression, but in the Des Moines Playhouse's production of Red, expressionist art takes center stage as well. I'm here with John, and John, can you tell us a little bit about this play?
Kelsey, you're late. The show's about to start.
Well, I'm excited to hear about what it's about. Yeah.
Well, it's about expressionist painter Mark Rothko, who took a commission to paint his great abstract expressionist paintings to go in a restaurant, which was the exact opposite of what he has been preaching his entire life about art. Into this world comes a young assistant who challenges him on everything he says versus what he does.
I know that the play actually won Best Play as a Tony.
2010, the Tony Award for Best Play, you bet, and it deserved it. It was just wonderful on the stage, and we're creating a lot of those fireworks right here at the Playhouse. You're going to have a great and unexpected, wonderful experience in the theater, an intense, exciting, clever, and funny, yet serious drama, all in about an hour and a half.
I'm here with Abraham Sweet, who plays Ken in the play Red. Now, before we start talking about your character, I want to know a little bit about you. What have you done before with acting?
Well, I am a newcomer here at the Playhouse, which means I've never done anything here before. So it's been kind of a really eye-opening experience to work at the Playhouse.
Can you tell me a little bit about your character, Ken?
Yeah, Ken is Mark Rothko's assistant. So I come in, I'm very overwhelmed. I think I'm going to be taught by this great master, which I am taught by him. But by the end of it, I'm really teaching him almost a lot more. We become sort of equals, as it were, in the play.
We're on the set of Red, and I'm here with, well, I don't really know where Tim is.
Hey, up here.
What are you doing up there?
I'm actually painting a skylight out black. So I know it sounds crazy. It's not something you'd ordinarily do, paint a skylight out black, but actually in Mark Rothko's studio, he actually controlled the light because he felt that his paintings were kind of babies and he wanted to control how the viewer saw them. So one of the things he did in his own studio was black out the skylights and really control the overhead light.
I feel like I've seen that before, that backdrop right there.
You actually have. All of these walls that you see behind us were actually used in Fiddler on the Roof. And now we've kind of consumed them and transformed them into the set for Red. And it's really a nice parallel for what happens in the show. Rothko talks a lot about the art of the next generation consuming the last generation.
Obviously, the color red's really important to the play. How did you incorporate it?
Well, there's little tinges of it. If you can see, a lot of the woodwork has a red grain into it. Even the water pipes over there, the fake water pipes, you can see the rust, the red. So there's real hints of that quality. And also the notion that it's in the middle of black. One of the things he talks about is black overtaking red, death kind of overtaking his passion and his desire for life. And so you kind of see hints of that in the set too.
This play sounds fantastic. How can people get tickets?
They can get tickets by stopping in at the Playhouse, 831 42nd Street, 277-6261, or dmplayhouse.com. We run through November 3rd. Even though it's under construction, we're up and operating, fully open. Give yourself a little extra time, but it's going to be well worth it.
Okay, and so be sure to check it out.
Yeah.